Alleluia, Alleluia. My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them, and they follow me. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On a certain Sabbath, Jesus went into the synagogue and taught. And there was a man there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and the Pharisees watched him closely to see if he would cure on the Sabbath, so that they might discover a reason to accuse him. But he realized their intentions and said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up and stand before us." And he rose and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil? To save life rather than to destroy?" Looking around at them all, he then said to him, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was restored. But they became enraged and discussed together what they might do to Jesus. My friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Our gospel today shows a test of human instinct. Human instinct. Alam niyo po ba yung human instinct? Yung kung ano yung unang mag-uudyok sa inyo. Tiningnan ko yung Tagalog ng instinct. Sabi doon sa Tagalog, instinto. Parang mahirap pa rin intindihin. So, tiningnan ko yung ipang ibig sabihin, hindi yung translation, no? Yung, kung ano yung una mong gagawin sa isang sitwasyon, kung ano yung mag-uudyok sa yung gawin mo. And that is what our gospel for today is trying to show. The test of human instinct. As Jesus was watched closely by the Pharisees and the scribes on what he would do on a Sabbath. This is not the first time that Jesus was called by the Pharisees for violating the Sabbath law. If you would remember last Saturday, that was the last time that he was also called because the Pharisees saw his disciples were picking grains, nangingitil ng uhaw, uhay, namimitas, and eating on a Sabbath. It is a no-no because working on a Sabbath is violating the Sabbath law. Yun yung last Saturday. Pangalawa na naman ngayon. Kaya tinitignan nila. In this case, more or less, they know already what Jesus would do. They feel that that Jesus will violate the Sabbath law again. That is why they are watching him closely. Binabantayan nila para meron silang maakusa kay Jesus. True enough, when Jesus saw the man with withered hand in the temple, he asked him to come over. But instead of immediately curing the man, or healing the man, he took the opportunity to even teach the people what to do in such situation. He took the opportunity. Tama naman si Jesus, no? Yun talaga instinct niya, no? Kapag mayroong parang mali, no? Magtuturo. Kaya alam niya eh, nararamdaman niya may mali eh, kasi may nanonood sa kanya, may nag-iisip sa kanya ng masama. Kaya he took the opportunity to teach. Hindi muna siya nagpagaling. And he asked them, "Is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil? To save life rather than to destroy?" Kung babalikan natin, bago nakita ni Jesus yung lalaking may withered hand, he was teaching. Kung baga, nagpa-recitation pa si Jesus sa pagtatanong niya sa kanila kung ano ang mabuting gawin sa araw ng pamamahinga. See that? Talaga si Jesus, no? Teacher talaga. He has that instinct, no? Nagpa-recitation pa. But no one dared to answer. Even the scholars of the law did not answer. And so, Jesus proceeded to heal the man. Para sa mga Pariseo at Eskriba, mali ang ginawa ni Jesus o mali ang ginagawa ni Jesus tuwing araw ng pamamahinga. Because this is not the first time. Dahil para sa kanila, nilalabag ni Jesus ang batas. But then again, if we're going to recall and go back to the question of Jesus, he was asking if it is lawful to do good on Sabbath. Alin ang naayon sa kautusan ang gumawa ng mabuti o gumawa ng masama sa araw ng pamamahinga? Ang tanong niya ay hindi kung ano ang tama, kundi kung ano ang mabuti. You see the difference? He was asking, what is it to do during Sabbath? The good or bad? Not the right or wrong. This is the instinct of Jesus. Every time he would see someone in need, to always do good, and not only to do what is right. Whatever the time, day, or season, the instinct of Jesus is always to do good. My dear brothers and sisters, we are being invited today by our gospel to check on our own human instinct. And how do we react on situations that we encounter? Such as the example, let's take a look at this. Seeing a man with a withered hand, what is our instinct? What do we do? Kapag meron tayong nakitang taong may sakit, do we heal them? Do we take care of them? Do we help them? O sabihin natin, hayaan mo na. Hindi naman ako nurse, ba't ako yung mag-aalaga? How about when we see people watching us? May mga taong nag-iisip ng di maganda sa atin. May mga taong nanchichismis sa atin. What is our human instinct? Patulan? Awayin? Or what about, what is our human instinct when we see a faucet na hindi naisara? Sa mall, nakabukas yung faucet. Is it our instinct to close it? O hayaan na eh, hindi ko naman to bahay? Or what is our instinct kapag may ilaw na nakabukas? Merong kalat sa sahig? Simple as these things. Check on our instinct. Is our instinct humane, makatao? Do we have a good instinct? This is what Jesus would want us to learn from our gospel today. Remember this, good instinct comes out only to those who have a pure heart. Amen.